So you might have noticed that up here on the right, I made a very simple chart to try and explain how Fibonacci behaves to myself. We're going to use this same sort of chart to make Fibonacci much faster by avoiding repeating a lot of work. And our official plan for this is going to be called Memoization. It's just like memorization, but missing an R. And here I've tried to draw two memos, a corporate memo, and those yellow sticky notes you sometimes see, where you could write a little memo to yourself. A memo in English is just a document, a small document that's written down, memorandum. Why bother with this? Well, it's going to turn out that our current implementation of Fibonacci is super slow. Let me try to prove that to you. So let's see how long it takes to do 100 trials of the 20th Fibonacci number. About 0.3 seconds. Let's up that a bit to the 24th Fibonacci number. Should take not that much longer, right? Oh, significantly longer. From 0.3 seconds to 1.75 seconds. We went up a huge amount. Let's go up to the 25th Fibonacci number. Whoa, we almost doubled. We're now at about 2.8 seconds. And in fact, we have reason to believe, based on human studies, that if a web page takes longer than 6 seconds to get back to you, you go somewhere else and buy something different online. So we're already using up a huge fraction of that budget just to compute the 25th Fibonacci number. And if you think about those trees I drew before, this is unsurprising. If we increase the number by one, we almost double the work at each step. So this is untenable. We need something faster. Our solution will be to write it down in a chart or a little memo to ourselves. I'll just make a table mapping n to the value of Fibonacci of n. 1, 1, 2, 3, 5, 8. And when I'm going to figure these out, I don't have to do a huge amount of work. Let's say I'm trying to figure out the 6th Fibonacci number. I can just look back in the table and reuse my old work. I don't need to recompute the 5th Fibonacci number. I already have it here. I'll just add those two chart cells together and get the answer. This is going to be our trick for making Fibonacci so much faster. It's called memoization. So we can implement our chart as a Python dictionary, just filling in the numbers as we compute them. So I can make an empty dictionary, assign mappings to my dictionary, and then check to see if something like 6 is recorded in my chart, and if it is, print out the result. And this is going to be super necessary now, and maybe it wasn't before. One of the keys to memoization is looking to see if you've already done the work and written it down. If you have, great, you can just reuse it. But if you haven't, you're going to have to go and compute it manually the first time.